One of the challenges many students face when they are trying to secure higher marks in creative writing is they find that they don't necessarily achieve great grades in their creative writing stories because the teachers tell them that their vocabulary is a little bit limited. The range of words that are used is not that great. Therefore, what I thought would be great is to put together a list of top 10 words that you can remember, which when you include this in your writing and in your storytelling, this will instantly make your story really amazing. It's gonna make it read much, much better. The vocabulary is far more ambitious. And these words sound quite fancy, very beautiful, but actually they're very, very simple and easy to understand, okay? So as you can see behind me, here's a list of 10 words that you can include in your creative writing. And indeed, to be honest, you can also include this in just your general essay writing, which if you do include it, will really rapidly increase the quality of your writing. Your writing will go from being very basic sentences to actually fairly sophisticated advanced sentences, okay? So let's look at these 10 words which you can include and what they mean and examples of how you can use them in sentences. So the first word is gilded, which means golden. Again, a word like golden, instead of using the golden rays of sunshine, you can say the sun's rays gilded something, okay? They painted it almost in a golden sheen, okay? So gilded simply means golden. And an example could be the ground was gilded with sunshine, rather than the ground was made golden by sunshine or by sun's rays. Again, here, as you can see, the difference in sentence quality is massive. It's completely two opposite extremes. The second word, which you can use, which instantly makes your writing sound super impressive, is torpid, which means tired. For example, I walked in a torpid haze, okay? You walked in a tired, lethargic haze, okay? So tired, lethargic, you can use the word torpid instead. The third word, which can make your writing, especially your creative writing story, sound genius, is somnambulant, okay? And I'm gonna spell this one for you. You might not have come across this one, so this one's a bit of a rare word, but it's a really fancy rare word that I would heavily encourage using in your writing. It's spelled S-O-M-N-A-M-B-U-L-A-N-T, which means sluggish, slow, okay? And actually you could say it's fairly similar to torpid, not necessarily synonyms, but they're fairly similar, okay? So somnambulant means sluggish, and you could, so an example of this sentence is the heat made me somnambulant, the somnambulant heat, or the creatures in the forest were somnambulant, they were sluggish, they were tired, they were walking slowly, okay? You can describe them instead as somnambulant. The fourth word, which is a fairly nice, clever word you can use, and it appears several times actually in Lord of the Flies, so William Golding loved to use this word, is festooned, which means decorated. For example, you could say the walls were festooned, were decorated with balloons, okay? Again, this is a really fancy word. Instead of saying decorated, which is a slightly more basic term, basic vocabulary, try to go for the more ambitious, festooned. The fifth word which you can use to instantly make your creative writing sound quite genius is bellicose, which means aggressive. For example, you can describe the bellicose dog, or my mom was acting in a bellicose manner toward me. Aggressive, okay? The sixth word you could use is crepuscular, which means twilight. Remember, twilight is that weird time in the evening or really early in the morning when either the sun is just coming out or the sun is just setting. This is when the sky looks like this mix of purple, amber, and it's quite dark, but it's either because the sun is setting or the sun is rising, okay? We will call that crepuscular or twilight. So instead of saying twilight, use the word crepuscular. For instance, you could describe the crepuscular sky. The seventh word you could use is preternatural, which just means unnatural, okay? So for example, you could say he ran with preternatural speed, Usain Bolt runs with preternatural speed, unnatural speed, okay? Or even you could talk about the preternatural feeling in a haunted house, the unnatural feeling. For example, if you're describing a supernatural character or a supernatural feeling to create some tension. Now, the eighth word you could use to make your creative writing story sound genius is coruscating. Coruscating means sparkling. So instead of sparkling or even glimmering, you could describe or talk about these coruscating diamonds, okay? Now, the ninth word, which I would suggest considering, is malodorous, which means smelly or stinky, so it smells. For instance, you could talk about the malodorous smell, which really, really overpowered you as you entered a tunnel. And the 10th and final word, which you could use to make your story sound amazing and even your writing more generally sound amazing, is tremulous, which means trembling. For example, if you're writing, for instance, a thriller story where somebody is trying to put together two wires in order to save their lives or in order to defuse a bomb, you could describe, "My tremulous hands clutched the wires as I tried to defuse the bombs," okay? So quickly to recap, the fancy 10 words which can make any creative writing story sound amazing are gilded, torpid, somnambulant, festooned, bellicose, crepuscular, preternatural, coruscating, malodorous, and tremulous. Please try your best to use it, you know, have a go at using all of these, right? Even begin off with just 10 sentences using all of these, and the more you use them, the more you're gonna find that your vocabulary really, really becomes more powerful, and you're gonna see this even reflected in your grades and the performance that you receive from school, because your teachers will be incredibly impressed. So thanks so much for listening.